How's it going? I'm Bub Tosh.
Jared Lintner.
And we're out here in the summertime on Santa Margarita, and we're out here throwing the newest bait by Paycheck Baits. It's called the Transporter. And it looks like a frog because it is a frog. It's a hollow body frog. It has a few different things about it that separate it from all the other baits. First thing, you know, right off the top, it has front legs. So when you see my bait, it's probably the only frog out there with front legs on it. Those legs actually do a couple things. When the bait's in the water, I don't have a front weight in the system. I just have the rear weight. And to me, a pointed nose frog or all other frog baits have the same action. And they're weighted the same, so they kind of just bob up and down and go through the water. And then it's up to you to impart the action to bring the fish to it. With this bait, by having front legs and the mouth design that it has, I'm able to put a lot of resistance on this bait. So where a typical frog, you would throw it out and start walking it back to the boat, it has to travel quite a ways in the water to walk, where this thing will stay almost in one spot and walk, and it'll almost turn 180s. It turns that good. The popper mouth is designed to throw water. When I say throw water, a couple different ways. The line tie position is in the very bottom, dead center, so it's more like a popping bait, more like a Rico. And I designed it that way because the Rico was always the best bait to throw. And what it does is it allows you to throw your frog out there, or your transporter, and walk it in the typical walk the dog action. Then you can pop it or gurgle it, and then you can make it spit water, and then you can start walking it again. So you can actually change up your retrieve 2, 3, 4 different ways in the same retrieve. So now you don't have to just throw your frog out there and walk it back to the boat, or just hop it straight back to the boat like everybody else. Now you can throw it out there, let it pause, give it a little bloop, let it pause, walk it a few times, spit it, bloop it, walk it. It's an unbelievable bait. It's a, like, you know, it's definitely a combination bait, and it's a great frog. I mean, when they're eating frogs, they crush this bait. The hook is a Gamagatsu hook. It's not the same hook as everybody uses. Everybody's really about the EWG hook. We have a round bend style hook, but the points are flared up. It's not widened out, they stick up. The top of our hook inside the harness is bent at a 60 degree angle. It's really hard to bend those Gamagatsu frog hooks, double hooks, up to 60 degrees, but every hook is bent inside that harness to 60 degrees. What that does is it allows you, when you set the hook, it creates a pull almost like a snail knot does. So the points always come up. You're trying to hook your fish in the top of the mouth and in the roof of the mouth. You're trying to avoid hooking them out here in the corner or in the bottom jaw. Those are fish you lose. Those are fish that jump and come off. So again, everything is geared towards hooking and landing more bigger fish. Inside this bait, the harness is bent to totally give away. We designed this bait to cave in around this hook. And when I say cave in around this hook, it doesn't matter if he comes from the front, from the side, from the back. You know, every bass isn't going to just strategically swim right up to the back and suck it right on the hooks. They're going to hit it from every angle. So if he comes from the side, your bait has to be able to collapse and totally expose the gap of that hook. This is the only frog that will do it from any angle. I want to show you.
The thing that I like about it also, I mean, this is the first day I've thrown it, but basically we got water, you know, this willow leaf grass here. Mm-hmm. So there's water around it. You throw a normal frog or even, you know, different brands of popping frogs, and it gurgles and it'll catch the grass. This thing, you can fish it right on top of that, and it spits like a Rico, and it's on the grass. So, I mean, it doesn't get hung up, and it's still, I mean, it's like fishing a Rico in the middle of a mat.
It's funny you say that. We thought about it a long time. We didn't want to make a popping mouth frog and have everybody say, oh, cool, you made a popping frog. We didn't make a popping frog. We made a different frog. The line tie and the position where it's at, the angle that it's down, it causes your bait to ride different in the water. And when you're pulling only on the chin of the bait instead of the head of the bait, you're not bogging your bait down in the water. So when anything does come in contact with the sides of the mouth or the arms and kind of loads this bait up, the position of the line tie is going to immediately just let that bait go ahead and rise over and skim over anything on the way back to the boat. So you're not going to bog up, you're not going to get the slime on your hooks, you're not going to have the same problems you do with a typical frog. But what you are going to be able to do is to have a much more versatile retrieve.
Oh, yeah, you know, I mean, how many times at the Delta or Clear Lake or other, you know, bigger lakes with a lot of grass, and you're fishing a frog, and you get a windy afternoon, and your frog's skimming across there, and you wish you had something to get some action, because those fish didn't leave the grass.
Absolutely.
They're still there, but they can't even see the bait, because it's just flying across the water.
Well, and frogs were designed to be subtle.